I don't want to put the place on fire. The principle of the pochon is called tenaz in Portuguese, is to put some extreme heat on the glass and then extreme cold. Then the glass will crack, the same way we do sabrage for champagne. We just, instead of doing that mechanically, it can be very messy with a bottle of port, and put a lot of red tinta barroca all around. So you need to heat the metal of the tenaz very high temperature, long enough, and apply it, at a, not moving it at a spot, where the heat can transfer to the glass, and immediately after, you put ice water, or ice cube, or even water, and thermal shock will crack the glass properly.
And I'm guessing one of the first things that you need to do as well, which I didn't see many of the contestants doing until maybe the second bottle or the third attempt, is, and to my mind this would be an obvious thing, that you need to remove the plastic coating from, so that it's directly metal on glass, is that correct?
Yeah, you need to take the capsule off, either you take it completely off, but the most important is to try to heat the metal the warmest possible. So you try to leave it the closest to the flame, in the warmest part of the flame. If you get it too far from the flame, then you don't heat the metal enough, you will not transfer enough energy to the glass, that will not crack. And you need to be patient, that's why you need to be a good sommelier and try to sell a fruit pairing in the meantime and try to entertain them about the Kruger Park and all the animals you can get. You know, waiting for your port and the sunset and everything like that.
And of course, timing-wise, how long should you give yourself for these tongs to warm up? 3 minutes?
Yes, something like 3 minutes to 4 minutes to make sure that you got enough energy in the tenaz, in the pochons. I know it's a lot of time, but they have 9 minutes for the task. So that's a moment where you can interact with the client. And yes, I know it's very dangerous to leave it hanging like that. I could see Soren getting a bit away of it. And that's why all of them decided to take it by hand. But even if you take it by hand, you try to keep it in place for safety issues. And always put some cold water next to you, because if you put the hot tongue on the table will catch fire. Which can be entertainment as well. But sommelier should not just be entertained with it. It's really good job.
Of course, indeed. So, the block is obviously for you to rest the tongs on.
The block is just now to put the tongue without messing up with my white linen.
And the tray.
You're supposed to get the opening in one time, so as soon as you finish, you can put the tongue in cold water to make sure that it's not dangerous for anyone coming around or falling on the table or falling on anyone. And yes, I use a tester lamp, but you can just use the water from, now it's getting very warm now, but with a tester lamp you can put a bit of water and ice to make sure the water is cold enough.
Do you want some ice from here?
No, it's fine, it's cold enough.
JV, what metal is it on the tongs?
You must ask Kimi because he's Portuguese. He's a Portuguese import. No, it's just rough metal, rough iron.
Okay.
Just rough iron.
So, I mean, it really does heat up.
Yeah, it can heat up a lot, and I'm not really worried about that. I'm more worried about putting the place on fire than getting my tenaz catching fire. I think you should be fine now.
That's a wonderful question, Angela. Thank you, because I think a lot of people are wondering, is it even possible for these things to warm up?
No, a 3D printer won't work. If you want to make your own at home, that would not work. Yes, thank you. I can see there is a full face in me.
Thank you, Chicago Fire.
I think now should be okay.
A moment of truth, ladies and gentlemen, almost here. And it's not necessary to wear goggles or glasses or protective eyewear or anything like that, because it shouldn't splinter and break into thousands of pieces, should it? It should just crack.
I don't know, maybe in America you should have to.
Health and safety here in South Africa, for those songs from abroad, health and safety is... It's a suggestion.
That's not cracking. That's not cracking.
Difficult.
Good glass. So it's South African glass made by Console Glass. We don't know the price of them and the fact they are the only supplier. But yes, it is extremely thick glass. That's why you cannot use a normal plier for that. But yes, I'm very surprised that
the other question I have is, should you not hold the hot tongs on the bottle for as long as 3 or 4 minutes?
Yeah, but otherwise you're gonna release the temperature along all the neck, and then all the neck you won't have a temperature contrast.
Gotcha.
The contrast of temperature makes that the bottle should crack. But yeah, this one is a very solid one. I can see that. I mean, port bottles are made to age for long. They're supposed to be, that's the one you find at the bottom of the sea.
Yeah.
They were made at the time hand blown.
Yeah.
Oh, mouth blown. And you just have to get time.
The kind of bottles that.
And very often you can see on Portuguese bottle, they got a small bulge on the side. This one doesn't have. That allows you to rest the tongue on it to make sure you don't break too low. Otherwise, if you break too low and you use panniers, then the wine will spill out, which is messy. And we try to avoid that as much as we can.
So does anybody have a hammer? Maybe we should use that on this bottle, just because we really want to take
it. I mean, I think at the last resort, you take your bottle opener and take a chance. You know? You eventually have to sell your client the wine that they've been ordering. But let's try again.
Leave it longer.
That would be an interesting question for the judges, in fact, in terms of marking. If any of the contestants had just taken a chance by opening the bottle, would they have been marked accordingly for at least getting something into the glass? Let's hear from Spencer. Yes, is the answer. So if they'd actually just taken the chance and opened it and maybe tried to find a way of sieving out the so-called broken cork.
Yeah, totally. The scoring criteria was actually weighted more towards the decanting, so that they never get to the decanting, you know, as the opportunity to score.
Now we know. Lovely. Okay, well, while we wait for something to happen, I mean,
many medals. Great one.
World Cup could be finished by the time we leave the room.
France have been winning anyway.
France have been winning. Geez, did you see how they tucked into the Argentinians at the finish there? It was final whistle, and then there was a proper big fight on the field. I don't know who started it. I like to think it was the Argentinians.